grace with Christ my Savior. Face to face, what will it be? When with rapture I behold him, Jesus Christ, darkling veil between. But a blessed day is coming when his glory shall be seen. Face to face shall I
Hand That Was Wounded for Me is the current song of the month. Mrs. Norheim, daughter JoAnne Wold, and I sing for you. You may have a free copy of Words and Music if you write to us and ask for yours. Just ask for the song of the month, The Hand That Was Wounded for Me, and address your letter to Lutheran Gospel Hour, Post Office Box 12, Pasadena, California. In Canada, it's Lutheran Gospel Hour, Post Office Box 201, Saskatoon, Saskatchewan.
Mansions above.
long howling winds that have left some trees in colder climes completely stripped of leaves have not succeeded to remove all the leaves on some trees, but when the warm breezes of springtime come and the frozen sap thaws out and expands, then what was impossible for the cold winds to do takes place miraculously when the warmed-up sap loosens the leaves and down they fall. This teaches us a valuable lesson on the great difference between compulsion and compassion. Outside pressures can produce a certain amount of results, but warm-hearted inner compassion does what nothing else can do. And oh, how we see this happening daily in lives God touches with his compassion, not least in people he has transformed from selfish, stingy, cold-hearted grabbers, changed by God's grace to be warm-hearted, sacrificial soul winners. Spontaneous givers are like cups running over, praise God. And we thank all who so cheerfully respond to the Lutheran Gospel Hour needs. You do remember that our mailing address is Lutheran Gospel Hour, Post Office Box 12, Pasadena, California, 91102. And in Canada, Lutheran Gospel Hour, Box 201, Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, S7K3K4. Repeated, Lutheran Gospel Hour, Box 12, Pasadena, California, 91102. In Canada, Lutheran Gospel Hour, Box 201, Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, S7K3K4.
To your attention today, a portion of the Word of God found in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 13, verses 3 to 9, in Jesus' name. And he spake many things unto them in parables, saying, Behold, a sower went forth to sow. And when he sowed, some seeds fell by the wayside, and the fowls came and devoured them up. Some fell upon stony places, where they had not much earth, and forthwith they sprung up, because they had no deepness of earth. And when the sun was up, they were scorched, and because they had no root, they withered away. And some fell among thorns, and the thorns sprung up and choked them. But other fell into good ground, and brought forth fruit, some an hundredfold, some sixtyfold, some thirtyfold. Who hath ears to hear, let him hear. And now, skipping down to verses 18 to 23, we find the interpretation thereof. Hear ye therefore the parable of the sower. When any one heareth the word of the kingdom and understandeth it not, then cometh the wicked one and catcheth away that which was sown in his heart. This is he which received seed by the wayside. But he that received the seed into stony places, the same is he that heareth the word, and anon with joy receiveth it. Yet hath he not root in himself, but endureth for a while. For when tribulation or persecution ariseth because of the word, by and by he is offended. He also that received seed among the thorns is he that heareth the word, and the care of this world, and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and he becometh unfruitful. But he that receiveth seed into the good ground is he that heareth the word and understandeth it, which also beareth fruit and bringeth forth some an hundredfold, some 60, some 30. Christ often made use of the parables in the scriptures in order that he might reveal the unknown by the known. In this instance, we have Christ as the sower of the good seed. The sower went forth to sow, and he found four different kinds of soil conditions. And that certainly not only suggests, but here it is interpreted as being four different kinds of heart conditions. And therefore, every time we step up to a microphone to preach the gospel, or if we in our own churches or in evangelistic work are preaching the word of God, we realize there are different kinds of listeners. We have the kind first mentioned here, the wayside hearer, mentioned in verses 18 and 19, very clearly set forth here in the word of God. When anyone heareth the word of the kingdom and understandeth it not, then cometh the wicked one and catcheth away that which was sown in his heart. This is he which receiveth seed by the wayside. Now, I have worked on the farm. I spent many years in my childhood in a North Dakota farm, and I knew the meaning of sowing the seed. We, of course, had drills and four horses. We found places where it was easy to sow, and other places the seeder just wouldn't get into the ground. The soil was too hard. And in our North Dakota farms, we had usually square sections and quarter sections. The roads were on the border of the fields, and occasionally you'd have some roads running through the fields. But it was quite different over in Palestine. There were roads running hither and thither in every direction. There were most of them pathways where people had walked. Now here the sower went out, and as we said at the beginning of the broadcast, he was not sowing with modern machinery, but dipping his hand into the bag, would pull out hands full of seed and throw these as he scattered them, broadcasted the seed around about him as far as he could throw it. Then as he threw it, some of it would land into good soil and other on places that were not really receptive for the seed, you might say. And so likewise, we have the trodden paths that run through the fields where the word of God should be gladly received, but it is not. You have these wayside hearers that don't understand the word of God. They don't intend to understand in the first place. They go to church because it's the right thing to do. They may occasionally turn on religious broadcasts because that's the right thing to do. But they don't understand. They don't grasp. They don't lay hold on these things that they should have. They simply do not understand. And so we find that while that beaten path, which is beaten down by the multiplicity of things that people are so interested in, yes, it could be possible right there by the radio now,
You're so busy with a conversation that's going hot and heavy that you hear only the sound of Pastor Norheim's voice, but you're not getting the message. You're a wayside hearer, my friend, if you listen without really paying attention. The wayside hearer is one that hears the voice, but he doesn't get the message. And when the sermon is over, he'll scratch his head and say, "Now, what was it I heard?" Nothing took a hold. The wayside hearer. Your business, your pleasures, the things that are dear to you have beaten a pathway right through the field, as it were, and you don't get the things that God intends for you to get. Yours is a pitiful situation, my friend, when business and pleasures and things of this life are so important that the Word of God can't find root in your heart and life. If you are unsaved, my friend, you can't complain of the fact that you work so hard 6 days in a week that now you feel sorry for yourself going to the house of God or listening to the radio. You'd like to entertain yourself in a more pleasurable way. You have beaten down a pathway that is so hard that now the Word of God can't gain entrance. The wayside hearer must know that he's under the judgment of God. You should have a heart that was cultivated, ready to receive, glad to receive the Word of God. But the wayside hearer is not. He is so taken up with the things of this world. And therefore I say, beware, lest you, being a wayside hearer, have missed the best that God intended for you. Then you have the surface hearer, which is mentioned in verses 20 and 21. And you notice here, "But he that received the seed into the stony places, the same as he that heareth the word, and anon with joy receiveth it. Yet hath he not root in himself, but endureth for a while. For when tribulation or persecution arises because of the word, by and by he is offended." Here I say we have a surface hearer. He's easily swayed, but he's shallow. He is awakened, and quite readily awakened, but he's not deeply convicted. Now, I have many times said that we need to have emotions in our religion, but if you have 100% or near to that of emotion, you have a very poor balance. If you are only emotional, but you're not heart-searching, if you're not willing to reason with God and surrender your will, then I say being a surface hearer will bring only surface results. And so you may follow the crowd, whether it be in revival or in the opposite way. But if you do follow in revival, you'll soon to backslide, because the word cannot get root in your life. You don't want to go down deep. And I say, unless you're willing to go as deep as the Holy Spirit wants to go in your life, you'll never know the meaning of becoming a rooted, grounded Christian. But I must hurry on. There's the compromise hearer mentioned in verse 22. And here you have the word. "He also receiveth seed among thorns, as he that heareth the word, and the care of this world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and he becometh unfruitful." This man, the compromise hearer, wants God and he wants the world. He wants the thorns and he wants the wheat. He's afraid of cultivation. He doesn't want to be stirred. He's one man that says, "I'm going to just reason this out. There's going to be no emotion in my life." And so when you come with a question, say, "Mister, are you really converted?" He'll snap back with his pet slogan, "Now you're judging." You see, he doesn't want any stirring, no interfering in his thought life. And it's soon evident the world has the mastery. There's no fruit. Yet the Bible says, "By their fruits ye shall know them." If you are a compromise hearer who profess to be a Christian, but your life shows that you are utterly worldly, then listen, you're also under the judgment of God. And you need that stirring in your soul that'll bring you to the foot of the cross where you'll cry to God for mercy. But I hasten on to the last mentioned, verse 23. "But he that receiveth seed into the good ground is he that heareth the word and understandeth it, which also beareth fruit and bringeth forth some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. The hearty hearer who understands the word of God. And why? Because he is of a better caliber than the others? Because he has a greater intellect? Because he has attended a Bible school or seminary? No. No one can understand the Word of God until, first of all, he intends to understand it by the aid of the Holy Spirit, so that he thereby may lay hold on Christ. my question in my confirmation book was, what is the true and living faith in Jesus Christ? And the answer, this is faith that a repentant sinner lays hold of Christ as his only Savior from sin, death, and the power of Satan, and that he seeks his only refuge in him and his merits, and with infinite confidence relies upon him. Here you have the hearty hearer who receives the word of God and lays hold on it. He permits the husbandman to plow and to cultivate and to pick out the stones and to pulverize the soil until he's worked over, and thus he becomes fruitful. And I want to say to you, my dear friend there by the radio today, if you let God have his way with you and your life so that the word shall be received with meekness, you shall be a hearty hearer who shall say, thank God for the gospel and sermon and song that has found its way into my heart. God grant it for his wonderful name's sake. Amen.
Oh, will you give heed to this message today, and to your convictions be true? There's danger and death in a further delay. My friend, he is now calling you. Oh, don't turn the Savior away. Oh, don't turn the Savior away. If you would seek mansions in heaven,